Reliance Industries Jamnagar, the world's largest grassroots refinery. A lot is known about the challenges involved in setting up this mega project. Yet, there are everyday challenges involved in operating this project. One of them is to protect the lives of thousands of people working here. It involves stepping up and elevating working standards, elevating work procedures, elevating safety culture of the plant. And whenever we talk of elevations, the first mention we give is to scaffoldings. Managing this aspect of engineering is an art as well as a science. Let's learn about scaffoldings at a deeper level.
Falls from height, mainly due to lack of or poor quality of work platforms like scaffolds, the most common cause of serious injury or death in industrial accidents. More than 50% of all major fatal accidents are as a result of falls. As per statistics published by LPA, more than 7,000 deaths were recorded in the recent years due to fall from height. In the UK too, 67 deaths and 4,000 major injuries were reported due to fall from height in 2003 and 4. What is work at height? A place is at height if a person could be injured falling from it, even if it is at or below ground level. It is our duty to do all that is reasonably practicable to prevent anyone falling. A simple three-step approach can prevent fall from height accidents. Firstly, avoid work at height where it is possible. This can be done by designing out the need for work at height. Secondly, use work equipment or other measures to prevent falls where working at height cannot be avoided, such as guardrails, permanent platforms and ladders, scaffolding, mobile work platforms or cradles, etc. And finally, where we cannot eliminate the risk of a fall, use work equipment or other measures to minimize the distance and consequence of a fall should one occur, such as safety nets, lifelines, safety harnesses and lanyards. At our site, we have witnessed many fall from height accidents, persons being struck by falling objects and several high potential near miss incidents related to work at height. These incidents are attributed to unsafe conditions resulting out of improper installation and assembly of work equipment such as scaffolds, lack of trained persons for scaffold erection, improper supervision, improper inspection and certification, non-compliance to work permit and work at height procedures, failure to ensure use of personal protective equipment, etc. Through this film, we have tried to show the various unsafe acts and unsafe conditions that cause injury to persons due to fall from height. We have mainly focused on proper use of and misuse of scaffolding, which is a commonly and widely used mode to carry out work at height. We have also demonstrated the safe way to construct, dismantle and use scaffolding. Our endeavor is to create awareness among supervisors and contractors on the hazards of work at height and educate them so that they ensure the following. All work at height is properly planned and organized. Hazards identified and adequate controls are applied. Those involved in work at height are trained and competent. Plan for emergencies and rescue. Equipment for work at height is appropriately selected and inspected. The risks from fragile surfaces are properly controlled. The risks from falling objects are properly controlled. Adhere to safe work permit systems. And last but not the least, train those who will be working at height how to avoid falling by use of appropriate personal protective equipments and how to avoid or minimize injury to themselves should they fall. Wishing you a safe viewing, let us begin the film on scaffolding safety and work at height.
Chapter 1, Erection of Scaffolding.
This is a standard base plate. While making scaffolding, the base plate is to be put on the ground. Put the horizontal pipe between two vertical pipes with the help of right angle coupler. Ensure that the pipes should not exceed more than 6 inch on either side of the vertical pipe. The bay length between these two vertical pipes should not be less than 2.5 meter and the height of the first horizontal pipe should not be less than 2.2 meter. It is for the easy access of the people below the scaffolding. This is 90 degree scaffolding coupler. It is used for connecting two pipes 90 degree to each other, as you can see in this scaffolding. This is a coupler. It is put on the vertical pipe and the pipe which is 90 degree to this pipe is put in this, as you can see here. This is swell coupler. As you see that it is getting swelled. It can be tilted in any direction. This is used in scaffolding for connecting the bracings. As you can see here, this is a vertical member and the bracing is to be attached with this vertical member, and here we provide the swell clamp. In this way, connect balance three horizontal members with the vertical members with the help of right angle coupler. This is clamp used for connecting the ladder with the scaffolding. As you see, this ladder is connected with the scaffolding pipe with the help of scaffolding coupler. In this manner, while making scaffolding, connect the ladder with the scaffolding in this manner and then go on connecting the horizontal member with the vertical member and complete the scaffolding. This is self-supported scaffolding and it is used in our refinery for construction, operation and maintenance. I will explain you the different features of tubular scaffolding. This is the base plate. It's a standard base plate and used for making the scaffolding. Different parts of this tubular scaffolding is couplers. This is a right angle coupler and this is swell coupler. These two couplers are being used for making the scaffolding. These are the tubular pipes. The color shows that these pipes are thoroughly inspected and ready for use to make the scaffolding. And after that, once it is used, it should have a color band on this. And only those color band pipes should be used for making the scaffolding. While making scaffolding, it should be kept in the mind that the extended portion of pipe should not be less than 6 inch and should not exceed 12 inches. It may hit the person passing by. If the extended portion of pipe is less than 6 inch, there are chances scaffolding may collapse. For making this scaffolding, we have to take the permit from the operation department, and the necessary risk assessment sheet is to be attached along with this permit. After making this permit, we have to fill a checklist. See this checklist. This is containing 15 points, and against each point, we have to put our remarks in the remark column. It may be either yes or no. If yes, we can use the scaffolding for the purpose. Or if it is no, then we have to correct that point first and then we can use it. After checking these points, this scaffolding is to be certified by contractor supervisor and maintenance engineer. Area around the scaffolding must be barricaded with the help of red and white tape while erection, dismantling or use of scaffolding. After certification of the scaffolding from the contractor supervisor and maintenance engineer, the status board of the scaffolding is to be replaced with the scaffolding complete ready for use board, and it should be displayed near the ladder. While putting ladders on the scaffolding, ensure that it should be 90 degree to the landing platform. As you can see in this scaffolding, and the ladder should be extended 1.1 meter above the landing platform. The landing platform, there should be a landing platform at 9 meter level.
Chapter 2, precautions while using scaffolding.
अरे 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 आप कहाँ चढ़ रहे हैं ऊपर? जरा नीचे उतरिए. आप देखते नहीं कि एक आदमी ऊपर से उतर रहा है, आप चढ़ रहे हो उधर से?
सर मैं ध्यान नहीं दिया.
नहीं ध्यान देने का, ऐसे कई एक्सीडेंट हो चुके हैं अपने यहाँ पर. भाई आपकी भी इसमें बराबर गलती है, एक आदमी नीचे से चढ़ रहा है, आप देखते नहीं हो हैं? और आपके साथ में और भी कई प्रॉब्लम्स दिख रही है मुझे. पहली चीज़ मैंने ये देखी आपके कि आपके दस्ताने दोनों फटे हुए हैं, और मैंने एक चीज़ आपकी और ऑब्जर्व करी है कि आप ये हाथ में लेके उतर रहे हैं, और ये चिन स्ट्रैप्स कौन लगाएगा? तो इस हेलमेट का चिन स्ट्रैप्स लगाना है. हेलमेट चिन स्ट्रैप्स नहीं लगाएंगे, हवा कई बार अपने यहाँ तेज चलती है तो हेलमेट गिर जाएगा. और यदि आपका देखो इसके ऊपर कई बार क्या होता है, ये ऑयल लगा रहता है. आपका यदि पैर स्लिप हुआ तो आप किसी स्ट्रक्चर से टकरा सकते हैं और आपके सर में चोट लग सकती है. ठीक है, इन बातों का जरा ध्यान रखिए.
Before using scaffolding, ensure that proper housekeeping is maintained. In the absence of right housekeeping, ascending or descending the scaffolding may be hazardous. Before erecting a scaffolding, ensure that there is a safe distance between scaffolding pipes and the industrial pipeline. oil-soaked shoes are slippery on ladder runs. Never allow anyone to sleep under stacked scaffoldings. In case of a collapse, it could be hazardous. Mr. Operator appears, has forgotten his harness and is working outside the railing. Due to inappropriate conditions of working and unsafe acts, falling of tools can be observed. While fixing a ladder on a scaffolding, please ensure that the ladder is resting on the ground. Ladder should not have missing rungs. Ensure proper clamping of the ladder on the scaffolding. Ladders should be clamped on the scaffolding minimum at two places to prevent any untoward incidents. Caution should be exercised while operating a crane near a scaffolding. Usage of a double lanyard is preferred while climbing on a scaffolding. Chapter 3, When It Strikes. A common observation found during the audits reveals absence of railings on scaffoldings, which by itself is a very serious threat. Never assemble a scaffolding too close to an excavated area. The scaffolding may collapse. Chapter 4, Dismantling. Always barricade the area around scaffolding before dismantling. While dismantling, remove the horizontal pipes first and then the bracings. Remove the ladder always at the last. Never throw clamps and other accessories down from the top while dismantling. Thank you. Remember, it could happen anywhere, anytime, with anyone. Let's prepare for a safe day today. I have no yesterday. Time took it away. Tomorrow may not be, but I have today.